At over 600 feet above sea level is St. Roch Hill in West Sussex, upon which stands the Iron Age fort of Trendle, now called the Trundle. Trendle is an old English word meaning a circle. The Trundle seems to have been in use right up until the Roman occupation of Britain and could therefore lay claim to being the site of the original settlement of Chichester. According to popular history, the city of Chichester was officially founded by the Romans in AD 43, and it was possibly the very first Roman city built in England. It is believed that the Roman Emperor Claudius appears to have appointed a previous Celtic king, Cogidubnus, as a Romanized puppet ruler over the old Atrebatic kingdom in southern Britain. The four actual wall gates of the Roman quadrants have all long gone, and only two of the Sentinel Tower locations remain. The exposed and preserved parts of Fishbourne Palace represent just the north wing of a structure that once occupied over 6 acres. At the centre of the city quadrants is the 8-buttressed Market Cross, which was erected in 1501 as a place for the country folk traders of the time to sell their goods free of city tolls. The Canon Gate dates from Richard III's time, and was the site of an annual court where peddlers' licences were both dispensed and enforced during the annual slow fair. In the grounds of Priory Park are said to be the remains of the foundations of Roger de Montgomery's diminutive Chichester Castle. Although the cathedral looks small, it is the third widest in England due to the chantries which were added in the 13th century. Chichester Cathedral is unique in England in having its campanile, or bell tower, located separately from the main building. The campanile was built in the first half of the 15th century. Richard de Witch became Bishop of Chichester in 1244. He died in 1253 and was canonised to St. Richard of Chichester in 1262. The interior of the cathedral has features both ancient and modern. The Bell Arundel screen was originally erected by Bishop Arundel in 1475. There are magnificent windows throughout the cathedral. Chichester has always had a maritime connection through the picturesque hamlet of Del Quay, which was at one time Chichester's port, located just over a mile from the city, and in the 15th century the 7th most important port in the country. It was largely built by Lord Fitzwilliam of Cowdray, but nothing remains of the port today save for the wharf. The threat to British shipping during the Napoleonic Wars posed by the French in the Straits of Dover led the Earl of Egremont to form a company charged with building a canal from London to Portsmouth, which would eliminate such danger. North of Stane Street and across the valley of the River Rother is Petworth, home to the great mansion of Petworth House. Midhurst is the next major township along the beautiful Rother Valley and is the site of Cowdray, one of the most impressive ruins of a Tudor mansion in the country. Bognor Regis, once famous pier, is now only a shadow of its former self. But Bognor has a popular seafront with several traditional attractions and, of course, long, shallow, sandy beaches. The commercial growth of Selsey prompted the building of an interesting light railway from the city of Chichester. Its engineer, the celebrated Colonel Stevens, created an endearing branch line railway in 1897 that ran right up to its closure in 1935. The old harbour at Pagham, which was once very popular with smugglers, has long gone, and the area is now entirely given over as a nature reserve. There are many species of flora and fauna to be observed here, but some areas necessarily have restricted access to preserve these fragile natural habitats. Littlehampton started life as a port at the mouth of the River Arun before becoming a holiday destination, and there is still some maritime industry operating today. Portsmouth is full of history and dedicated museums, but its two major attractions are probably the historic dockyard and the Spinnaker Tower. The Spinnaker Tower stands over 550 feet high and first opened in 2005. This 30,000-ton concrete and steel edifice took 6 years to plan and 5 years to build. The district of Arundel was given its first earl, Roger de Montgomery, by William of Normandy, following the Norman invasion in 1066. Montgomery took up residence in the castle in 1067, and he was also responsible for building the small fortification inside the city walls of Chichester. Chichester retains an impressive balance of the historic against the modern, and both it and its environs are wonderful areas for living, working and recreation. So let's now briefly review some of the highlights of this short visit. We hope you have enjoyed this film, and for your information, we have included a number of useful contacts at the end. Thank you for watching.